All right, I'm back. Just had to do a small errand there. You saw, if you watched my last video, the intensity was pretty good. Actually, I had me sweating. I really don't sweat often at all. I did a 6 mile run. Given it was in the middle of the night and it wasn't hot at all, but I barely sweat, but that had me sweating. But part of it was me picking myself up on the chair too, which I'm not going to do for this next exercise. So all I'm going to do is move these up. And as you saw, if you go back and watch my last video, I had an issue with these, the suction cups starting to get loose and falling off of me. So that's something I'll be watching. But and once again, I explained in the first video, I'll be running the cycle for the regular abs. This is what you see right here. This is what the recommended layout, and I'm not going to be doing that for this. I'll be moving them higher on my abs and doing something that's not in the books. So I've done it before. It's kind of one of the things I wish that what's this company named? Compex, whatever. I wish they'd come out with some more info. Because I know there's more possibilities to their products that they don't talk about. And when I do this, you know, I switch it up even more and I go further out. So maybe that's why it fries me so good. But that's what I do here. So we'll see what happens. Maybe I'll go in the shock or something. Who knows? I'm already pretty much there. So I'm just gonna get right into it. If this is the first video of mine you're watching for this device, go ahead and watch one of my other ones. There's two other ones for some more information, because I'm not gonna go over it every time. The big thing is, especially when you're doing these custom jobs, you want to be doing the same thing on both sides. I mean, it could be a little off, but overall, you know, you want to be doing the same thing, so you're working your body out the same at the very least. And speaking about that, I could tell that this one's further out. I placed these two closer to my chest, and this one's further out. So I'm placing this one closer. And then I'm just gonna relocate this one really quick. So now looking down my chest, they're about even distance away from the middle. They're about even distance up and down on the side. This one looks way further out. Over here, that looks pretty good. Over here, the one on top looks too far out. It's easier when I actually look at the computer screen myself instead of my body. It does look, though, it looks like I'm higher up on this side. I'm higher up on this side, and on this side I dip down. So I'm gonna bring this side up. Now this side looks further out. So I'm gonna make one last adjustment and bring this side a little bit in. And this right here is all experimental. Like I said, this is not a program. I'm gonna be running the regular ab program, but doing this. But I think actually now that I brought it closer in, I really am mimicking the regular ab program. I think that's good enough. It's good enough. I'm done messing with them. And the more you mess with them, the more you waste the sticky stuff, the suction capability. So here we go. This is my own custom loader right here. So you're gonna watch me do this before you do it. See what happens. My device here auto timed off, so we're just gonna turn it back on and start up the cycle really quick. Hypertrophy. Like I said, we're gonna be doing this cycle right here, even though it looks like it's for the bottom abs, we have it up top. So let's turn them all on. Press all four buttons at the same time. Or one by one, whatever you want, and then it shows okay, they're all on, good to go. And we're set. Next time I'll be watching big time, because if you watched my first video, you saw that I had a problem with the puck slipping. All right, so in this video, I'm just gonna, because it's harder on the abs, I'm not gonna be doing anything else in addition to this exercise. And also the fact that I want to make sure that these things are going to stay stuck, because they're coming down to their last couple uses here. Which, it's something you should take into account when buying this product. It's expensive to begin with, but then also, you have to replace these suction cups. So there's not only the upfront cost, but there's a maintenance cost as well associated with it. So on my lower abs, I got the 140s as far as intensity. And in the past, I've not been able to even get close to that when I bring it here to my higher up, my upper abs. For whatever reason, I'm not sure. Maybe it's a smaller muscle group, less fat, I don't know. Because here, obviously, I have a little gut, you know, to help absorb some electricity. I don't know if that helps it at all. Whereas in my upper abs, it's more straight to the muscle. Speaking about the fat, that's one of the reasons I like running this program on the abs. Is there's a lot of things about exercise and body physiology that I don't believe in. I don't believe in a lot of stuff in modern science, but I do believe that they say that the body burns fat where it wants to burn fat, and that if I work out my abs, it's not going to burn fat necessarily on my abs, but it's going to burn wherever it wants, wherever the last place it put it on my body. But at the same time, if you work out your abs, you're increasing your muscle mass in your abs, which is something I'm more interested in doing. I don't really care about burning fat. I don't really care about my fat percentage. I care about the looks and increasing my muscle mass. So I'd rather bring my muscle to my fat than shrink my fat all the way down to my muscle. Because I like my fat content, you know, you need that. So I'm hoping to increase my muscle content by working out my abs with this, other exercises too. But we'll get into all that later. But I'm just showcasing this product for now. So it started at 6, which is like half the number. It started at my lower abs, so that's telling me that the device itself is detecting that my upper abs can handle less voltage or amperage, or I'm not even sure the proper, honestly, I don't even know the correct term, but it could handle a smaller number than my bottom abs. We're going to crank it up pretty quick here. I think we'll get to like 60 or 70, and then that's gonna be it. Maybe more, I don't know. All right, here we are at 60, 63, 65, depending on the device, on the hockey puck. You know, honestly, it feels like I kind of want to lift myself up on the chair a little bit like I was doing before, but man, it really got my wrist. It was my weak point there. My wrist. But I want to compare the feeling of engaging my abs while running this exercise. So here we go. Once again, it feels, and I'm referencing my past video, it feels like I can handle more of the higher number when I'm actually lifting up and engaging my abs. So on the same note, it should mean that if I flex my abs, it'll have a similar effect, and it does. So I'm gonna do that instead, just to give my wrist a rest, because the last thing I need right now is some sort of, this one's coming off. See, watch it. The last thing I need right now is to jack up my wrist. That one came off, so yeah, it's definitely time. Definitely time. Thankfully, I'm gonna finish the cycle, man. I could just go like this the whole time and hold these suckers to me. Ah, that's how it's gonna be. What did I say? Oh, for my next cycle, on my chest, it uses different shape, different size suction cups that I've used less overall, so I should not have this problem. Estoy muy grande. We're in the '70s right now. So, we got higher than I thought. I'm at 100. It's not quite the 140 in my lower abs, but doing better than I thought.
Yeah.
Looks like I'm almost back up to the 140. I'll probably get there. I think what it has to do with is the positioning. I think the four, I had him further out. And the further out I put him, the less I could do. That might be it. Once again, that's why I'm doing these videos, to try to document this process. Start collecting data for it. This is kind of a new device. Coming towards the end here. Coming towards the end of the life of these section cups are real. That one just fell off, and you saw the device stop completely, which is good. But it has to fall all the way off for it to register. It has to fall all the way off. You've seen it fall partially off, it keeps on going, but that time it fell all the way off, and the device detected the lapse of circuit and stopped the cycle, which is good. And then it looks like it backed down my intensity too, but I'm not going to mess with that right now. I'm just concerned about finishing the cycle without having it fall off again, and then I'll move on to my chest and maybe go on a run today and call it a day. No, but probably lift some weights. So there you have it. This is my third video I've made. The third cycle I've ran. On video at least. I've run a lot more. The third cycle on video. The first custom cycle on video. And already, if you've been following them, we've learned a couple things together. I would guess, as far as these suction cups wearing down right now, I would guess I've used these suction cups in particular probably 25 to 30 times. So that's about how much use you get out of them. I forget how much they cost. They're definitely not cheap, but I don't think they're too bad either. But, yeah, this one's coming off. I'm about to order some new ones, so that's what I'll do. I'll order some new suction cups, and at that point, I'll make a video going over the whole device, the box, everything it come with.
all that good stuff. So that's what I'll do, because these ones, it's getting now to the dangerous point when they're falling off. Because like I said, it's pretty sharp pain when they fall halfway off. That's pretty decent pain going on. Because it's sending all that. It's not even halfway. It's like, just hanging on by like a quarter. Sending all that juice through that tiny part of my body. And my nerves were just like, help. And I looked down and saw that. Stuck it back, and then it was fine. But obviously, it's something you want to avoid by purchasing extra sticky pads. Maybe even, I would recommend it when you make your first investment. Just go ahead and buy them right then. At least one extra set, because it comes up pretty quick. Yeah, that one just fell off. So after this, I'm gonna end this video and then upload one last one for my chest. That'll be it for now. There we go, cycle complete. One more video coming up.